provide my own milk.
Thank you.
We brought the snow globe with us this evening. Thank you guys for trusting us to spend your evening with us.
It's amazing to be here in Madison Square Garden right now. And I was just realizing, you know, we started this tour, this is the second half of the tour. We started this tour like almost a year ago, right? It's probably been close to a year ago. And so I would go out and I'd say, oh yeah, this song is now 21 years old. Drink. So, it's an oldie. Not an oldie, right? But if you know it, you gotta sing along, right?
Absolutely bizarre that we're playing these specific songs at a sold-out show at Madison Square Garden in 2024. Because none of this was really supposed to happen, right? Like, it wasn't put together. It was just like a punk band. It was not supposed to happen. but it fucking did. And usually I would just stop right there, because I know that's the moment, right? You know, just keep going with the show. But listen, I'm gonna explain it, because we tried to get signed by every fucking record label out there. We have so many rejection letters, it's absolutely insane. This little record label from Florida called Fool by Ramen signed Canada again. And then, you know, we were like, what's next? We wanna make it all happen. And eventually we ended up putting out another record, and it was not played on the radio, it wasn't played anywhere, and by sheer fucking force of our fan base, who was watching the video, who shoved it up the charts on Tiro, made this fucking thing happen. So that's how it fucking happened.
Receptionist, they want.
Thank you.
Like Patrick said, I guess we're about a year past So Much for Stardust coming out. And if reflecting back on that album and the Pixie show, and so much of it is just about the feeling of existential doom, you know, like, for me at least, like, when I walk into any room with anybody, I'm just like, my mind just fucking freaks out and is like, one day, all these people in this room, including yourself, will not exist anymore. And it, like, well, I don't know, like, it's a tough one to clap for. But, and like, the world feeds us these, like, things to numb ourselves, right? Like, it's like you just scroll forever, right? And I found that the only time I don't feel like that is when I'm making shit with my friends. And so I would encourage you to do things to make the world a weirder place, whether you're making TikToks or bracelets or films. I see a lot of the weird shit you make. It's pretty weird and pretty great. I think that if no one else is telling you, I'm telling you right now that the shit that you make is important.
Stop crying.
guys be aware from the seats over there.
Oh, it's gotta be louder than that.
How are you doing way up in the seats over here? How are you guys doing way up in the seats over here? How about you motherfuckers all the way in the back? This one doesn't have words for about half the song, so sing them with us.
I want
Thank you guys. That looked fantastic. But it was impossible, maybe if there's some people that are rocking out all the way over here, up there, we can just pull them down on the side. Yeah? Excellent. You really, you know, when your kids just crayoning nicely, they're just drawing nicely, you leave for a minute and you come back and they've drawn all over the fucking wall and you're like, well, it looks cool, but it's pretty fucking crazy. This is how I feel you handled the set list this evening. It's pretty fucking wild.
I love it's all me somehow.
Well, it's all you if it's good. If it's bad,
yeah, if it's bad.
I'll take the credit for it.
All right. Oh, no, it was the other way, right? It was bad, they'll blame me, and it was good. You go, hey!
Perfect.
Look at the set list that made.
Fucking love it. This is what our podcast would be something like.
I don't want to do a podcast. I'm talking way too much.
I feel like we could get 2 or 3 listeners. All right, see you later.
Hi, guys! So, you know, Pete talks a lot about on stage. First off, who's here? Hi. Good to see you. If you have seen this before, you know I usually don't talk on stage. And part of the joke is that because I ramble a lot, so if I start, I don't stop. So I'll try and be brief. Pete talks a lot about how, you know, this wasn't supposed to happen, kind of, and, you know, it's kind of amazing and weird. We were a side project. Pete and Andy had, like, real bands, and so I didn't think it was going to last. I was like, okay, whatever, I'll do this and go to college. But we're still here somehow, and it's crazy. And there's a thing I wanted to talk a little bit, briefly, about, I mentioned this before, about imposter syndrome. Right? Where you think you're not good at the thing, or you think you're gonna, at some point someone's gonna figure out that you're no good or whatever. And the thing is that at the end of the day, I will always be this little, you know, like fat 8-year-old, right? Like that was like, it's like, oh, I'm no good or whatever. But the secret that I wish I could tell that kid, and so if there's anybody in here like that kid, is that the kid that I was, is that no one's gonna tell you. Just do it. You belong. And if I could tell 8-year-old me that I would get to write the song that I'm gonna play, it would blow his little mind. So I'm gonna say I don't think I've ever played this one live. I don't know if you're gonna be so angry, but some of you will. Some of you will, not everyone. Let's see how this goes. Be your friendly neighbor. Wild imagination. I got to. They let me do that. But so, a bunch of years ago, I was feeling really down about myself, you know, what I was talking. I picked up some words of Pete's. Let me be. Said I'd be fine till the hospital.
Connor, can we take the lights in the house down? Excellent. Now, if you have a cell phone, it would be fantastic if you do the lights on this one. And I would also say, if you ever get the chance to dress your favorite basketball player in a disco cowboy suit, absolutely fucking do it.
Thank you.
It's not me, it's you. Actually, it's the taxidermy of you and me. I'm tied to balloons around my neck around me. I'm just melted wax on a birthday cake. Another year fades away. Charcoal crushed, pixel fever, angel dust. Stuck in a wasteland, we cover as litter. And broadcast just for a little serotonin. Self-sabotage at best, under your spell. But you know what they say, if you want a job done right, you gotta do it yourself. This palace is crystal, but the world is a cruel joke. What is there between us, if not a little annihilation?
Thank you.
You guys feeling all right still? This is the first time that anyone has ever reacted like that was magic. You're amazing. We have to give you a call-out for sure or something. This must be how an actual magician feels. He was like astonished. It was excellent. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna get you a call-out for sure. Right? I don't know if we make any that little, but we're gonna get you something. Is there a way if we play another new one? To the Magic 8 Ball portion of the evening. Where dreams are made, sometimes hearts are broken. Get into it, everyone. Is this tour ever gonna fucking end? Is this tour ever gonna end? We play a pretty old song. sometimes you just gotta be psyched when the plane lands. Alright, well. Oh. Alright. Should we just call it a night? Very mysterious. Should we just call it a night? Should we just fucking slow down?
Kiss me like a drum.
Alright, so right here. Thanks, William. Right here is where we get off stage and hopefully play an encore. But instead, we're just gonna stay out here and play some more songs if that's alright.
So, we've been on this tour around the world for the last year, and there's a giant crew that makes this happen every single night. We start early and the end late, and please make sure you're the best fucking crew on the planet. New York City, make some fucking noise for yourself. Can we take a picture with all you before we get out of here?
Thank you. Thank you guys. New York City, you're a dream. We'll see you next time.